added, "Why we switch back from the stars?" Added, "Wait until, wait until backdrop number equals 2.
Congratulations, global warming has ended.
Wow.
Okay, so I
have been awarded the Nobel Peace Prize.
I hit the Nobel Prize.
Oh! السلام عليكم عبد الله.
وعليكم السلام.
Can you tell us what are you doing?
I am finishing up my code for a competition.
Uh-huh, nice. What competition is that?
The competition is the Code Ever 2022 competition.
Very nice.
It is hosted by Stampedia.
Very nice. And what project?
A game.
What is the theme about this?
Ending global warming. It was made to spread awareness about global warming.
And very nice. When did you start learning to code using this?
A few months ago, about 8 months.
And you are using Picto blocks, as I see now. Do you find Picto blocks a good language to code using it?
Yes.
Why is that?
Advantages and disadvantages.
What advantages?
The extensions are very big advantages, mm-hmm. And also being able to connect to hardware.
Oh, and that's very nice. Okay, can you demonstrate for us the game?
So as you can see, this is the opening screen. It gives information about it.
Okay.
You want to do the tutorial, yes or no?
For this, I'm going to be doing no.
Okay, so I press no.
Show us the tutorial. Again with the tutorial.
With the tutorial. Very nice. Okay.
Now, for some reason today, the computer is being very glitchy. This isn't supposed to happen.
It's okay. So, you're doing these clicks. And what these clicks do?
They get rid of 1 metric ton of CO2 in the air.
1 metric ton of CO2. I can see that you have at the very bottom this bar showing the...
How much metric tons of CO2 much are in the air.
In the air. And it's reduced each time you do a click. Very nice. Until
like 500 million.
Mm-hmm. So I can't see the power.
The money, actually.
The money. So what do you do to see it?
You press P.
You press P.
Press P to see your money. So I have clicked 46 times, so I have 46 money. Now I've clicked 50 46 more.
46 money.
So now I have 54, because I clicked 54 times.
Okay.
I can go to as much as I want. But
okay.
So you get money from all over the world. This is not just one specific country. Not like in dollars, like people from Switzerland, Canada, all over the world.
Okay. So, what you pressed on advancement?
Yeah.
You get
and
the shop?
And now I can shop. Which means I can get things that I spend money on. Mm-hmm. And these give me upgrades so I can play the game easier and go through it quicker. To get rid of the more metric tons of CO2 in the air easier.
Okay, so you have working. What do you mean by working?
Working like means workers that work.
And small company?
Small company is like a small company that makes you money automatically.
Okay.
And that gets rid of metric tons of CO2 in the air.
And what about advertisement?
They double the amount of money you get per click on the earth.
And why do you, what does this bill ring means?
That means you bought it.
I bought it.
But let's say you don't have enough money for something.
Okay, so what's the money now? Oh, gives you this. Okay.
Well, unless you're on UN funding, then.
Okay, so you press the arrows.
You were vetoed by a country and you need 6,000 money to prove you are capable.
That's what happens when you click on UN funding. Like, you didn't have enough money to prove that you are capable.
Collaboration, also collaboration between countries.
Not countries, companies.
Companies.
For example, you collaborate with Google.
Okay, and larger company.
Machinery.
It means
like you get bigger machines to remove more metric tons of CO2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now to buy more things, you have two pages and that's it. And then there you can press X to leave. And let's say you don't want to see your money. You press E.
When this game will end?
When you reach 500 million metric tons of CO2.
The normal, is it?
Yes.
Do you want to remove all the CO2 in the air?
No, that will cause very big problems, probably.
Such as
massive plant life destruction.
That's very nice, Abdullah. And what happens to someone who ended the game, in the game?
They get the Nobel Prize.
The Nobel Prize.
I forgot to mention something.
About
when you press H.
Do you want to do the tutorial? Yes or no?
It brings up the tutorial again.
Okay.
Yes.
You'll answer yes this time.
You must stop global warming by starting a company.
Starting a company or the other tools.
Click on the earth to get money and remove CO2 in the air. You can see your money by pressing P, and you can hide your money by pressing E.
P and E. Very nice. Let's have a look at the code.
Okay, so I'll start with click effect.
Click effect.
Okay, click effect is basically, like, I'll show you. So when I click on the earth, this appears. This is the click effect. Basically, when it is clicked, it goes, it sets its size, then it shows. Then, whenever you click on the earth, it sends a message. When it receives the message, it goes to front layer. It goes on top of the earth, because if it was under, then it won't show. It will go to the mouse pointer, it will change its Y by 7 and move 38 steps, and it will broadcast the 8th message.
Let's go back to the earth code.
The earth.
Can you show me the control structures you have in your earth code?
Wait until.
What else you're using?
Wait. Say if. If then else 2 times. If something is equal to something, like for example a variable is equal to 1, then go change y by 10.
Yes, and I can see that you are using the send message and receive message.
Yeah, I use events a lot. Like why do I need this? So for example, the when flag clicked, it allows to start the whole code.
Good.
Yeah, and then when the other ones, for example, when space craft key pressed, if someone presses H,
do you want to do the tutorial? Yes or no?
This was called.
Okay, so what do you call this?
Events.
Do you have events? Okay, can you show me the backgrounds that
backdrops,
you have in your backdrops in your code?
Opening screen.
The other one?
Stars, the backdrop for the earth. A shop, the place where you bought
the shop.
The first shop.
The first shop.
The second shop.
The second shop. Very nice. And can you go back to the variables? And show us how many variables.
The variables are the most important thing. Without the variables, this whole code would break and it would not function.
Why do you use variables for?
Like, for example, I'd use a variable to make something only happen once.
Only happens once. And
For example, like here, I used a variable called once in the code. So basically, when it would be done with a certain action, if once equal to one, then it would do the thing, and then it would change once by one, so it would be guaranteed to never happen again.
That's nice. And
unless I set once to one again.
And where do you store, which variable store metric ton of CO2?
Metric tons of CO2 in the air, that's the variable.
This one?
Yes. So basically what these do is dictate the price of things. So the cost is minus something, but it can only be bought with the absolute of the cost.
So you are using the absolute function. What does this absolute function?
Absolute function basically, in simple terms, makes a negative number positive.
Very nice. And what other operators have you used in your code?
What other mathematics have you used?
Mathematical.
Multiplication.
Multiplication.
Equal to, greater than.
Okay. And
I think pick random.
Pick random.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was gonna say that. So basically what happens is that it changes price by price times 3.
Mm-hmm.
And then it changes cost by random from half price to price. So if half price was 5 and price was 10, it would choose one random between them.
Very nice. Abdullah, can you tell us what looks you have used in your code?
Okay, say hello. Say thing for 2 seconds, for a specific amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
Not switch costume. Switch backdrop.
Mm-hmm.
Next backdrop, I think I meant to say.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Set size. I've used show and hide.
Mm-hmm.
And I've used layers. So like here in the click effect, I made it so that whenever you'd click on it, it would go to front layer. So it would be a layer above the earth. But when it would be done, it would go down to the back layer, the layer behind the earth. So it wouldn't be visible. That's... instead of just using hide and show.
Can you show us the sound that you use?
Okay, so sounds, the ching sound, this one.
Okay, when you buy and the...
whenever you click on the earth, then this sound happens.
Mm. And what's
at
this?
At the end of the game, there are 2 sounds.
Okay.
That happen when they tell you you've gotten another card.
Oh. Ah, there's...
this?
Okay, because we didn't reach to this stage. Oh, very nice.
So these are overlapped. If you want to hear the sound at the end of the game, then I'll...
that... oh!
They're overlapped.
You overlap 2 sounds. That's very nice. Okay, Abdullah. I've seen too many things moving, rotating.
I used turn. I used the forever loop and put turn in it.
And show us the code for example, the larger company, larger machinery, Sprite.
Larger machinery is the same as small company.
Okay, but...
It's better. But it's more expensive.
More expensive.
I'll show you the unique ones. Click effect, earth, new and funding, and advancement.
Thank you, Abdullah. Surely this was an excellent demonstration and excellent work. I hope you win this competition and the Nobel Prize.
You're welcome.